off as a management and staff here at the Petite Chateau and the Northumberland Registration Service, I'd like to welcome you here today to witness the marriage of Graham and Vanessa. We offer a very warm welcome and are delighted you're here today to share this special occasion with them as they celebrate the beginning of their new life together as husband and wife. Graham and Vanessa have spent many happy hours planning today. And have chosen this wonderful venue and their own special words, readings and music. And they hope that you take home some very happy memories to share with them in their future life together.
I belong in your arms. Finally, I have found a place into which I fit perfectly, safely and securely, with no doubts. No fears, no sadness, no tears. This place is filled with happiness and laughter, yet it is spacious enough to allow me the freedom to move around, to live my life and be myself. This wonderful place, which I never believed really existed, I have found finally. Inside your arms, inside your heart, inside your love.
May I have your full name, please?
Graham Wood.
And may I have your full name?
Vanessa Theresa Rowe.
This place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriage. If any person knows of any lawful impediment why Graham and Vanessa may not be joined in marriage, you should declare it now. Before you promise yourselves to each other in marriage, it is my duty to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. And now I'm going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you do not know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. I declare that I know of no legal reason.
That I know of no legal reason.
Why I, Graham Wood, may not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Vanessa Theresa Rowe.
Vanessa Theresa Rowe.
I declare that I know of no legal reason.
That I know of no legal reason.
Why I, Vanessa Theresa Rowe. May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Graham Wood. And the purpose of marriage is that you may continue to love and care for and support each other through all the joys and sorrows of life, and that love may be fulfilled in a relationship of permanent and continuing commitment. And we trust that these things will come true for you both. Now, Graham and Vanessa wish to marry each other, but in each other's company they have found fulfilment and love. They have drawn closer to each other and now wish to affirm their relationship, offering each other the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. And by taking these vows, you are undertaking a commitment to cherish and support each other faithfully throughout your life together. So just have to turn your badge. The institution of marriage must be entered into freely, voluntarily, and with the full and unreserved consent of you both. Therefore, do you, Graham, take Vanessa here present to be your lawful wedded wife, to be loving, loyal and faithful to her for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
And you, Vanessa? Do you, Vanessa, take Graham here present to be your lawful wedded husband, to be loving, loyal and faithful to him for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
So just remain facing each other. But for now, in the presence of your family and friends, you're going to enter into your legal contract of marriage. So you just repeat that to me. I call upon
these persons here present.
To witness that I, Graham Wood,
To take thee, Vanessa Theresa Rowe.
To be my lawful wedded wife. I call upon
these persons here present.
To witness that I, Vanessa Teresa Rowe.
To witness that I, Vanessa Teresa Rowe.
Do take thee, Graham Wood.
Do take thee, Graham Wood.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
With that, there's a huge round of applause. Graham and Vanessa have chosen two very special personal promises which they would like to say to each other. I promise that I, Graham.
I promise that I, Graham.
Accept you as my one true love.
Accept you as my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
What may come, I will always be there.
What may come, I will always be there.
I will give you my hand to hold.
As I give you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
I promise to give you my love and friendship.
I promise to give you my love and friendship.
To be there for you when you need me the most.
To be there for you when you need me the most.
To laugh with you, to cry with you.
To laugh with you and to cry with you.
To confide and trust you.
To confide and trust in you.
To comfort and support you.
To comfort and support you.
To share all that I have with you.
To share all that I have with you. To share all that I have with you. To respect you and be faithful always.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
Marriage is by Emily Matthews. Someone to believe in and to put their trust in you. Someone who appreciates the special things you do. Someone to be close to in your heart and mind. Someone who's the love you might have thought you'd never find. Someone who stands by you and whose faith can make you strong. Someone you will cherish every day your whole life long.
We now come to a significant part of the wedding ceremony, which is the giving and the receiving of the wedding rings. This is an ancient and traditional way of sealing the contract you have now made, and is the outward sign of the vows you have made to each other. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle, symbolising unending and everlasting love, and reflects the lifelong promises you have made to each other here today. So Stephen and Graham, could we have the rings? I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
May it remind us of this moment.
May it remind us of this moment.
And the commitment I have made to you.
And the commitment I have made to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
May it remind us of this moment.
May it remind us of this moment.
And the commitment I have made to you.
And the commitment I have made to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
So, Graham and Vanessa, you have both made the declarations required by law and have made solemn and binding promises to each other. And I ask all your family and friends here today, having witnessed this marriage ceremony and your commitments to each other, to join with me in wishing you both success and happiness in your future life together. And it therefore gives me great pleasure, Raymond and Vanessa, to declare you are now united as husband and wife witness.
Your week. For those who don't know, I'm Graham, Vanessa's dad. Oh, hi. A warm welcome to everybody here today to celebrate this wedding. Sorry about this. I've got nervous.
Need to do
your non-friends. Scott and I would like to extend a very warm welcome to Ken and Jean, their family, all of our relatives and all our friends for coming here today to enjoy this day. Fortunately, I'm just a warm-up act. Unfortunately for you, it gets a bit confused because there's three Grahams here. To follow me, I'm sure the best is to go. During the time we've been here, we've come to realise how good these two are for each other. One's a saver, one's a spender. It's going to be some interesting time there. We're into very the tactical board. Any chance to come his way, he always finds a way to conquer them. He's very good at everything. Teaches me how to do the EBM. I find him a really generous person. Yeah. As many a time I've had a season ticket. And now it's a premiership next season. I hope that's going to continue. That is the premiership, George. Not the championship. When Graham asked to marry Vanessa, he said he wanted to make her happy for the rest of her life. And that's all we've ever really wanted for Vanessa. So may I take this occasion to formally welcome Graham to our family. Now it's you, Vanessa. This could take some time. We've always been very proud of Vanessa. I'm pleased to see her looking beautiful today. So happy. Yeah. Over the years, we've watched her grow from a gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous and little baby girl to the wonderful, beautiful woman she is today. Vanessa's a wonderful person. She's always got a smile. She's always made us laugh. Smile and laugh and sometimes shake my head. But she's the most caring person I've ever come across. Yeah. For those who don't know, Vanessa was born in South Africa. And one of my very first visitors was George and Sandra. They really became her first auntie and uncle. And I'm very pleased to welcome them here today. I'm pleased to put me here. Keeping up with South African traditions, we'll have a barbecue tonight. Vanessa always enjoyed school. And Here, one man here, after being there about 3 or 4 months, to tell us her future job in life was going to be a dinner lady. People were surprised because she never had seen dinner. Very much a little girl, she loved her dancing in her body and had all the medals and cups on the mantelpiece to show for it. Then a love of horses developed. She'd wait for hours and hours every weekend looking at the horses and coming back. Go, come out in the mud. I know that stuff. What a smell. Barb used to make her get changed in the heat of it. I always used to feel sorry for her. Fortunately, she never requested a horse. So I'm going to leave that to him. I think a lot of horses have encouraged her to come to the races with us and feel with that people in the other room on many occasions in Newcastle. But I never actually ever saw her watch a race. And I don't think she got up to Marquee. Vanessa went to Thomas Moore, excelled academically, loved languages, and went on to get her degree at university. After studying and filling in the time on these long holidays at university, she took many a part-time job. One of them was at the Newcastle United supporter shop, where when a woman asked for some discount, she was given her the whole third degree, and it turned out it was Kevin Keegan's wife. David Ginola was the big favourite at that time. Spring bed was quite important. There was even photographs of the kitchen. The remarkable thing was the bar that I'll give. The next job she had for a short time was at Metro Lab, the Metro Center. Through this, she became firm friends with Lisa, Leanne, and Catherine, and their many friends, and even went on to become godmother to Leanne's daughter, Mia. Mia was 18 and 1 year, and she's a beautiful girl, and I think we should all be happy about that. Vanessa shared lots of holidays with Mia and her friends, and all the children, and the groups got bigger and bigger every year. I think it's been going about 10 years now. And they enjoy it that much, they all take their own holidays, but nobody ever misses the group holiday. It's a firm fixture on the calendar. While leaving uni, she started at Standard Life Financial Services. It was a wonderful company to work for, so she tells me, and her mum tells me that as well. Weekend started on a Thursday night at 5 o'clock, and ended up with a hangover on Monday morning. And many requests for Monday morning. She met Lisa, Sarah, and all her friends there, and that became another great social party. Weekends I used to end up being the chauffeur on Saturday or Sunday night, as they used to do the town, the big market, the popular place. Of course, Vanessa being Vanessa, she used to lose her key quite often. And on one occasion I can remember, well, this was the next year, 2 years later, she asked for another key, and I said, well, where's your key? Oh, I lost it on Sunday. And then it turned out that people on the ladders from the side of the house put them up to the bedroom and climb in. But being a tiny girl, she went and put the ladders away before the bedroom. She was a little bit weird. She thought I had safety on the aspect of losing kids. It's just one big game of thrones from the patio door. just took many of the sunshine holidays, then joined skiing holidays, she's joined us on skiing holidays, and we're quite lucky this week because usually it could be in Glastonbury. She'd be driving a camper van with six people down the Glastonbury driving the back. It would have to be a camper van, there's no mud or wellies or tents for Vanessa, it's got to be something nice and comfortable. Her other interests, I seem to remember, were the pigeon club we gained at Blackpool. Don't begin to do either. I wish you at least one, I never know. But you'll never miss them as well. Even though Vanessa works pretty hard and has got a hectic social life, we always had time for her grand. And unfortunately, she's to take her to the bingo every Friday, but her granddad passed away. And then the two of them used to really enjoy each other's company. So much so, we were quite worried at the time, but we didn't know who was the worst for each other. It used to be about 1 o'clock in the morning when she got in on it. It was 12 o'clock, the fish and chips on Newton Road. And we had some really good time together.
In the push-up bra!
I think there was a time where I thought we could be advice, so that's happily for you, it's the end. I think these two have lived together for a couple of years, and from what we can see, they don't need any advice at all. They seem to handle everything really well. The only bit of advice I could say give them is to be there for each other in all the good times and all the bad times. So with that, I think I'd propose a toast to Vanessa and Bridget.
Anyone who doesn't know me, I'm Woody's twin brother. Those who don't know me know I'm his very proud father. Today is a wonderful day for Graham and Vanessa. It's the day that they commit to each other and they start their married life together. And for family members, friends and relations, it's a day to share in their joy and their happiness. Graham, I couldn't be happier for you as you have found a wonderful match in Vanessa, and I truly believe that you'll be happy together. Oh. Vanessa, welcome into our family, and I wish you everything you dream of for the future. And keep this short and sweet, so to everyone else, I propose a toast to the bride and groom, to their marriage, to the love they share, and to their future. Graham and Vanessa.
Thank you to the two parents, the two fathers, for their kind words. I'm going to keep it short and sweet because I've been told to. Directing groom's speech isn't something you prepare for every day, so you're going to have to bear with this because this is all of your own work. A lot of it's off Google. Firstly, let us welcome you all to our wedding celebration. It really does mean the world to it that we've got so many friends, family, loved ones all here to celebrate our marriage. I hope you all enjoy our special day. But just not too much. Did somebody just check this knee red wing on that? Now, I'm not going to bore you all with the story of how me and Vanessa first met, or how our first date went, or I'm sure you know it all already, and if you don't, Please tell me he goes up that road 5 pints. I've totally forgot his name. Instead, on that note, I'd like to charge all of everybody to charge your glasses for the first of my toasts today. And the reason, the real reason we're all here. The work she's put in to get this all together over the last few months while working a normal, hectic week has been nothing short of phenomenal.
Yeah.
Spent weeks thinking about exactly what you would look like today and what I imagined. You don't even come close. You look absolutely stunning. So you've done me, you and my families proud. You're not only beautiful on the inside, you're not only beautiful on the outside. You're the most caring, loyal, and generous person I've ever met. Not only beautiful on the outside. Today I am truly honored to call you my wife. Wow. My beautiful bride. I'd like to say a beautiful welcome to our parents, both for your emotional and financial support. Especially leading up to date, it's been absolutely overwhelming. The Bart and Graham for welcoming me into their beautiful family with open arms and trusting me to take care of your daughter. Also, to my own parents, Jean and Ken, for bringing me up in spectacular fashion. Shaping me into the man that stands before you today. I make you as proud as you still make me. Well, on behalf of Vanessa and myself, we'll have a small token of our appreciation for the parents. None of you have got sick of this. For your love, care and support, I will be forever truly grateful. Also, to our beautiful bridesmaids, Mia, Ellie and Jessica and Leila, thank you for helping Vanessa today. You really have done us proud. Now then, Next, to you beautiful lot, our guests. Scrubble, all right, actually. Special mentions to the guests that have travelled that extra mile to be here. Family from Germany, friends and colleagues from London, Birmingham and Nottingham, and Burden. So ladies, watch your handbag. Now the secondary tools I would like to name is the people of the room who are no longer with us. So this one is for absent friends. So back on to a lighter note, Team Tenerife. All those have travelled for 4 days in the sunshine from his start to. It's made it absolutely unforgettable, and it wouldn't have been the same if Warriors hadn't been there. And to those who joined with the town at the Time Bank Brewery to carry on the celebrations, which was possibly hotter than So just before I hand you over to the best men, I'd like to personally thank our master of ceremonies, Tim. And all the staff, the photographers, everybody who's been involved in making this day happen. Couldn't have happened without you. It's absolutely fantastic. So I think I've stalled enough now. And against me better judgment. I'm going to hand you over to the best men. Difficult for us to be too complimentary because I'm not quite sure what's going to happen. Letting these two loose for the microphone. See, they're going to end up like a night in Cozy Joe's. Or I'm about to be divorced. Anyway, thank you all for coming. Here's the best man.
First of all, I don't normally do this with microphones, I'm just like shouting at people, but I'm going to calm it down there, so. Then a couple of lads over there, know when I get a microphone in hand, I know I'm singing their Dizzy Rascal songs and bonk that, but I'm not going to do that today. So, we'll carry on. But, how do you start to speak like that, buddy? You know what I mean? So I thought, and I planned it, no problem, and then Tim, he said, he's opened a line before, I can nick that, brilliant. No, I don't realise Tim's down 2 yards away from it. So, I think it's funny, but Tim's not even in the eye. So it's a nice breaker. We need a nice breaker. Yes, we'll see how we go. So, not that I'm pinching anyone's lines. I didn't think Tim was going to be there. I'm pinching Tim's lines. But as an intro, I'm not the fat, bald, short ass. Yeah. About breakfasts and breakfast, and it was brilliant, but if it comes down to dinner, tea, beans, pap lunches, I know nothing about that, so we'll move straight on. Yeah. But yes, for this is normally proper start after I say I nicked Austin. But good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Graham. You're the Graham, the third Graham of the day. And this is Stephen. And we had a great honour of being the best men today. So before I start, I'd like to thank you all for coming and helping make Graham and Vanessa's wedding day such a memorable and special occasion. Especially this beautiful and, as Graham wanted me to tell you, very lavish and then very expensive. The Petite Chateau. So what is the Petite Chateau? And it's basically the small house.
Is that right?
On the script, but we need to kick this out of your house for now. It is actually, yes. But I have to say before we go on, not because it's a tradition
But it's to be said that because it's the fact that Vanessa, and I want to say Vanessa and the bridesmaids, you look stunning and beautiful today. Yeah. And we emailed about before, and then I found out his brother Hans Pearson is really handsome. Make your own mind up for now. Indeed. So I hope it comes to some comfort to both parents and Val, Graham, and Jean and Kenny, who are footing the bill for today's proceedings. I just went round and asked a couple of lads, I think, on the back table there. Before we sat down, and they thought, what the thought of the small house or the Petite Chateau or coming? And they said, it seems quite kind, like. But bear in mind, these are the same lads that went to Tenerife and thought that spending just £14 a night at a B&B that did no part of beds, no breakfast, and had the most ridiculous spiral staircase, which I was going to go to describe, would be kind of funny. Absolute death trap. He also thought that this hotel was canny. As I say, well, I'm Graham, and in today's speech, just had the privilege, along with Stephen, as being one of Graham's best men. But I can't keep calling him Graham. Yeah, I know I call him that anyway. He's known as Woody to everybody. Yeah. So, we'll come out and call him Woody. So, when Woody asked us to be best man for the day, to be honest, I didn't say yes. I didn't say no. I just thought, Jesus, Woody's getting married. Ladies and gentlemen, I have to write this down. Ladies and gentlemen, believe it, we are actually at, I'm going to quote this, we are actually at the wedding of Woody. The Scottish King of the Denton, the Scottish Two of the Barmaids, who are probably some of being young here, the Scottish Blurman of the ladies from Gorman's, who's actually got himself married, but he did say he always going to be the last man standing. Vanessa, what have you done? Speaking of the Denton, looking around all the faces in the room, I'm sure we could have actually crammed everybody in the upstairs lounge, that's near you, so they're still there. Could have been there, because we'll certainly see about supplying the buses to take us back there, because believe it or not, that's where the actually after party is tonight. Tell the bus driver. So it's that time of day when it's our job to say one or two things about Woody. And a few jokes, a few stories, you can imagine there's probably one or two. So I hope everyone's got the next week off work. It's going to take a while. Although I did promise already, yes, that in part for Fortune Kelly Megan, it wouldn't be long because you'll probably need a towel in 5 minutes. So welcome, Mr. Well, I don't know if anyone knows, I've known Woody since we started middle school together. I can honestly say in that 20 years plus, which is, man, that is frightening. 20, nearly 30 years. But I've never sworn him. I've never pushed him. I've never kicked him. And I've never actually wanted to put my hands on his neck in trouble. Never. But there was one occasion when I've happily done all four. Woody, and you well know what the story is, but you didn't tell it on mine. When you were Woody was my best man at my wedding, did a brilliant job. You didn't tell it, and he did ask if you could ask tell it on my wedding. But you didn't, that was great. You didn't tell it on my wedding day, and I'm not going to tell it either. But ladies and gentlemen, that's not because it's boring or it's not funny. It's because to this day, neither my parents or Jean and Ken know what went on. I can't believe it when I say it, if they did, would let me kill a room in with you.
I've always done the same thing.
It's two things.
That was an experience with the police that, yes, was regrettable. Now your mum's going to start asking me questions there. What was that story? Now I shall tell it now. You don't just tell it. But I know it's a full house here today, and lately we're kind of getting going, so I've been told off the staff. But there are a few people that couldn't make it today. I think it's because I weren't given an invite, but there's a reason why for that. But there's four people in particular that couldn't make it. Would have loved to come here, but that asked us to say, why didn't we get the invite? The first person is he's called Big Lawrence, and he's a big 6'8" black Irish woman on the doors of the Red Sea. And Woody would have a normally weekly Friday chat about half past 11 with him. But he'd nick it in, you know, I've got my fake ID, I've got my pass, I've got my things coming in. Then he'd have him in. But then, about 2 hours, 3 hours later, he used to have another chat. And when I say a chat, it was normally when Woody was pleading for mercy after being thrown out of emergency exit into the alleyway and fearing for his own safety. But I told him to come back in. The second one is I think his title right is a Sergeant Major Douglas, and he's from the Jesuit branch of the Newcastle Army Cadets. I don't know if anyone knows what he used to be in the Army Cadets. He really is. But probably wants his fake ID back. You see, by the time you got married, yeah, surely you're not old enough to get into circus service. And also, can he have his beret back with the little fluffy colour? Where is that now? Nobody knows. And also, thirdly, is a fella called Mick Hall. No one will know him. I knew him very well, first game to him. He lives at 15 Ronald Drive, we're all next to one of the other. Now, I say I knew him because I know him spoke to him to bail him out of the chaos he caused on parties and doing whatever. And he says, he's the bloke who bought 13 Ronald Drive from you. And quote him, he's a far better neighbour. Apparently, no time has he ever threatened to kill his coy cop, dress up all in black as a ninja, and look over his back fence. And we all thought you liked that once. And lastly, is a Mr. Hussein. And you won't know because I was on first name too, so you were off into the town when I met him. Before you ask, he's not the bloke who used to buy our special red off. With 2 litre bottles on a Friday night, crop it down, get the last bus home. She never knew what drunk. Sure. But Mr. Hussein used to be the manager of the Tuxedo Princess, which we all know is that floating boat on the River Tyne. He said that Vanessa and Graham are more than welcome to have their first dance on his dirty dance floor. But unfortunately, through no fault of his own, it actually sunk last week, which was on 10 days news. So he kind of, and when he was speaking, he wasn't very happy that someone had damaged some of his property. And we all know between the two, this episode is very touchy on damaged property. But that's who couldn't make it today, but I got waffled off long enough, but he said, I was expecting this thing to be waved around a bit more, but we might have just got away with it. So I'll pass it on to Stephen now and see what he's got.
Anyway, Tenerife, the stag do. Great. I absolutely couldn't Tenerife. There was people sleeping with cleaners' cupboards, there was others forgetting room keys being dragged into the ditch by their feet. Welsh to sleep through the lot, I don't know who that was. A red wine man up there was seeing him, flew in one day. Stayed from about 6 months and flew back the next day, didn't he? Before we went through that, what happens on a stag do stays on a stag do. Apart from the photos, which we need to get up going over there on the screen, don't we? Yes.
Say that I've been say that it's all because of you. If anyone should ever write my life story. Take good care of my baby. Please don't ever make her blue. Just tell her that you love her. Make sure you're thinking of her in everything you say and do. Take good care of my baby. Now don't you ever make her cry. Just let your love surround her. Paint a rainbow all around her. Don't let her see a cloudy sky. Once upon a time, that little girl was mine. If I'd been true, I know she'd never be with you. So take good care of my baby. Be just as kind as you can be.